Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about API gateway pattern. I mean, this API gateway term is like a common. It's being used everywhere. In most of the applications which are either on AWS, Azure, GCP, they might be using some kind of API gateway. Okay, so we will understand what is the need of it, what API gateway is, what additional features it is providing to our application. Okay. So think about it like we have a different microservices and different microservices directly talking to the client. Your client can be a desktop client, mobile client, or web client. Okay. So in that case, what all challenges you will face if your old set of microservices are directly exposed to the connected clients, like connected clients from browser, from mobile, from desktop, all these set of clients you have, right? In this case, where microservices are exposed, they are actually directly exposed to these all different clients, right? So most commonly challenge is some microservices will be talking with the gRPC, some microservices will be talking to HTTP protocol, some microservices are talking in terms of AMQP protocol, right? These are different protocols in which microservices will be talking to either clients or to one another, right? So in that case, this is an inconsistency we have. We don't have a homogeneous set of connections where client is just directly talking to single entity and then that single entity is talking to a different microservices in their own language, okay? AMQP, okay, gRPC, okay, RPC, or HTTP. Then that API gateway is sending the final message back to the client, okay? So this is why we need API gateway. API gateway is a single entry point, you can say. So let's see this architecture diagram and try to understand this. Okay, so you can see this API gateway here. We have HTML browser, either a native application is also accessing that or third party application. There is a single entry point. So it is very easy to implement authentication, authorization, because all the clients will have to go through this API gateway implementation, right? So all these set of features, so what all features this API gateway will add on? One picture we have seen without API gateway where your web application is directly, your backend applications are directly talking to the different clients. So you are managing the authentication for Android application separately, for web application separately, for third party application separately, and your backend services are directly exposed to the client. I mean, your services are directly exposed. Here we have API gateway. So there is a single entry point. Your services first will talk to API gateway and then API gateway will take care of talking to the backend services and taking the response back. Okay. So here you can see when you don't have a API gateway, then you actually your front end, either it is Android app or either it is a web app or desktop app, Electron app, all are directly exposed and we are actually calling the backend services directly, right? So in that case, we actually lost that principle. Here, backend services are exposed, right? So how we can convert it? We can convert it by installing an API gateway. An API gateway will take care of calling these individual services and will give the response to the client. Now, get order details, okay? Get order, get delivery, get bill, and get restaurant order. API gateway will do that. You just need to make a one single API call. Here we were trying to make a multiple API call to multiple services, right? Here you just make a one single API call, get order detail, rest API gateway will take care. We have to write some implementation here. Okay, get order detail, okay? Create a sequence of events and just call this service, that service, okay? So what functionality that API gateway will provide, we will talk about that. Okay, so basic API gateway, I think we got the understanding. So we have a different implementations available. You can use these outside vendors like Apigee, or you can just use AWS API gateway. Similarly, Azure might be having gateway. These gateways can be a single point of contact for your microservices world. After API gateway, you can have your Lambda, you can have your authorizer Lambda, or you can have all set of microservices deployed on AWS infra. Similarly, you might be using Azure or your own infrastructure using on Kubernetes or somewhere, right? So this API gateway is doing that thing. Okay, let's talk more about API gateway in the second part of it.